Hello, my name is Dan Michelson, and I'm an aquatic biologist with the Department of Wildlife Resources. And we're going to talk about the striper fishery at Bugs Island Lake, or John H. Kerr Reservoir, today. Kerr Reservoir was dammed back about in the mid-50s, and it's the damming of the two rivers, the Dan and the Stanton. But it's a very unique fishery in that it's one of the only ones in the country that has natural reproduction. There's enough room up the Stanton River especially, and the Dan, where they can go up, spawn, and the eggs can float back down to the Bugs Island Lake where they hatch. So this is a very unique feature that most other reservoirs in the country do not have. We also have been supplementally stocking for years. One of the ways that we assess that fishery is using gill net. And what those are 8-foot panel by 200-foot long monofilament nets that we set just below the surface of the water in the fall. We set those things in October, November, and December, and we set 6 nets each night. So the fish run into the nets and get tangled up in them. They can't see them when they're in the water. We harvest or bring those fish in and work them up at a boat shed in Clarksville. When we're working those fish up, we'll take lengths and weights. And what we really want to know from them is their growth rate. So we take a small bone out of their inner ear called an otolith. So we do have to sacrifice the stripers when we bring them in to look at that. But it's a very few fish compared to the total population out there. And it's vital information that we have to have. So we can estimate their age. Those otoliths get a growth ring on them, just like a tree. So we can tell what ages they are at certain sizes, which tells us how fast they're growing. We can also estimate how their survival is on an annual basis that way, and even tell how many fish are entering the fishery in a given year based on all of that information we're collecting from those gill nets. So with all that information, we then set our stocking rates, and those stocking rates are really based on the fact that we have to optimize that fishery. We can't simply stock as many fish as we'd like to out there, because we do have to keep in mind that all those fish species are competing for the same forage sources. We've got a huge blue catfish population, we've got a really good largemouth bass fishery, and one of the best crappie fisheries in the southeastern United States, and I have to consider all of those populations when we think about stocking rates. In the past, we have stocked really high rates and saw some big declines in growth rates in the stripers. So what we're trying to avoid is that, and trying to optimize that stocking rate so that all the anglers can be happy with what they're seeing out there. So the striper fishery at Bugs Island Lake is a good fishery. It's never going to be a trophy fishery like Smith Mountain Lake, simply because of habitat limitation. Bugs Island Lake is a reservoir down on the North Carolina border. So as you can imagine, it gets pretty warm out there in the summer months. The stripers are a cool water species, so when water temperatures get high in July and August, they tend to struggle and have mortality rates that go up a little bit. Also, the growth rates tend to settle down or slow down that time of the year because their metabolism rates are very high and they're burning a lot of energy just trying to stay alive and active in the cooler water that they can find. Other issues that have come up with that fishery, the productivity of the system has really started to decline over the years. Land use practices in the watershed have declined, not as much farming and row crop farming. Having said all of that, it's still an excellent fishery. The top end of those fish, usually about 10 pounds. You see a lot of fisheries out there, fish out there that are in that 24-inch range, and that's a lot of fish that people like to catch just for eating, especially. We've got great partners out there that help us with the management of the fishery. The U.S. Army Corps of Engineers has helped us with habitat work, sampling of the fish species, all different types of species out there, not just the stripers. So they're an invaluable partner that we have out there. Another one is a private group called the North Carolina Virginia Striper Club, and those guys are great with helping me make management decisions and really being the barometer, telling me what they're seeing out there, because it's more important to me what the fishermen are seeing than anything else out there. So we're planning on doing a little bit more with this series. We're going to be talking about striped bass production this spring, where we'll actually work with the hatchery staff and show you how we collect those fish from the Stanton River as they're running up the river. So look for that this spring. It should be a pretty cool feature. If you'd like more information on the striper fishery, please visit our website or give me a call. I'd be happy to talk to you about it. I'd love to see you out there on Bugs Island Lake, and have a great day on the water.